PGD, or pre-implantation genetic diagnosis, was developed to identify certain chromosomal abnormalities in the embryos. This technique is used for those patients older than 37 years of age, patients with recurrent miscarriages, as well as to identify the gender of the embryo. Now, Medfem Clinic, 5 different probes and therefore 5 different chromosomes are tested. These chromosomes are chromosome X, chromosome Y, 13, 18 and 21. In your body you will find 2 chromosomes in each and every cell. The chromosomes in a human body is 6 numbers and therefore 23 pairs. So for instance, you would have 2 21s, 2 13s, 2 18s, and then coming to the gender chromosomes, you have either XX, which will indicate a female, or XY, which will indicate a male. Now, the first step in pre-implantation genetic diagnosis is in vitro fertilization. The second step then would be to isolate a single cell from a day 3 embryo. These embryos should be six to eight cell stage on day 3. With the help of a micromanipulator, which is a very sophisticated machine, and under an inverted microscope, one will then stabilize the embryo. The next step would be to make a little hole in the zona or the capsule of the embryo with a very tiny micro glass pipette. The next step would be to isolate or biopsy a single cell from this embryo without damaging the embryo. The embryo would then go back into culture, safe and sound in the incubator, while the single cell will be following the following steps. First of all, the single cell will be swelled by a specific medium, then fixed, then the DNA will be denatured and hybridized with commercially available probes. Now, this is very technical, and it means that we are going to stain the DNA, those specific chromosomes we're going to look at, with different colors of fluorescent dye. And after staining the single cell, we will be able to identify these different chromosomes by using a fluorescent microscope. So therefore, we will look at different colors under the fluorescent microscope. For instance, the X chromosome will have a purple color, the Y chromosome a golden color, then 13 would have a red color, 18 aqua color, and then we're looking at 21 with green colors. So when we do look at this single cell under the fluorescent microscope, we should in normal circumstances either see 2 purple signals or colors, which means it's an X, the female embryo, or then an X and a Y, which is a purple and a golden color, which will indicate a male embryo, and then only 2 signals, green signals, or 2 and 2 aqua signals, 2 red signals, and that would indicate a normal embryo. As soon as we see an extra color or even 1 signal less, which means only, like for instance, 13, which will then be red, and we only see 1 signal, we know that we need another chromosome prior to identifying this single cell as normal, and therefore then the embryo as normal. After evaluation, we will then label the normal embryos as well as the gender of those embryos by indicating it on the outside of the dish, our cultured dish. And inside, of course, it will be the embryo, which will be cultured in the medium and overlaid by oil. Now, it's very important, although the embryo could be chromosomally normal for those 5 chromosomes we were testing, we also have to look at the development of the embryo as well as the morphological status of the embryo. And therefore, we will only transfer these embryos on day 5 or even day 6 when we are satisfied that these embryos are good quality blastocysts. With other words, there has to be a good inner cell mass as well as a trophic tetram. Now, although I've said we would like to transfer blastocysts, we can also transfer morulas and compacted morulas. The most important thing is that this embryo should be able, we should have the ability to develop and progress and grow. The final step will then be to do an embryo transfer, as either in day 5 or even